Good afternoon everyone. So yesterday we started one more new chapter on chemical kinetics. We have discussed some of the chemical kinetics, but in that rate of reaction. And what is the rate of reaction? How to express the rate of reaction with respect to the reactants and the products and corresponding numericals we have done in the last class. And now in today's class we will discuss about rate equation. Or rate law corresponding order, everything. Anyhow, some of the points about the rate equation already we covered in the last class, so we'll continue. Anyhow, just we'll revise that part and we will continue. It is a rate equation means it is a representation of a rate of reaction in terms of concentration of reactants. So for a particular reaction, for a general reaction, let me take AA plus BB gives rise to CC and DD. For this rate we can write like this, some rate constant a power x and concentration b power y, and where the powers x and y may or may not be equal to the stoichiometric coefficients of the reactants a and b. So this x and y that will come through the experimental data, and here a and b, the stoichiometric coefficients are theoretical, but here x and y are experimental. So for the rate, so this is we are expressing in terms of the reactants. So we can write decreasing in concentration of reactant by dt. In place of rate we can write like this, is equals to k into a power x and b power y, and this kind of the form is called a differential form of rate of reaction. This is known as the differential rate equation. If we express in terms of this change in concentration of reactant with respect to the reaction constant and the concentration of reactants, everything, that form we can call differential rate equation. Where k is the rate constant or specific rate or velocity constant, we can say, and a b concentration, x y the powers, and here x plus y, this is the sum of powers of all concentration terms involved in the rate equation, is called order. Already we have discussed this. Order means it is the sum of the powers of concentration terms. Sum of powers of concentration terms which involved in rate law equation or rate equation, and this order is experimental value, so it may be 0 or it may be positive or it may be negative or it may be fractional. Already we have discussed that this is a 0, positive, negative, fractional. It is not a theoretical value. By looking into the equation, you cannot identify what is the order of the reaction. We can calculate through experiment only. It is only experimental data. But a few reactions case, we can say the stoichiometric coefficient, the sum of the stoichiometric coefficients of a particular reaction can take such an order, that is only for elementary reactions. Generally, we have two types of reactions here. One is elementary reaction and the second one complex reactions. Elementary reaction means the reactions which occurs in single step. Complex reactions means which occur more than two steps. Again, about this elementary and complex reaction we will discuss later, but till then, for elementary reactions, elementary reactions means which occurs in single step. Or simply single step reactions. Then how we'll come to know whether the reaction is single step or multi step? Again, that is an experimental phenomena. We cannot say by looking into the chemical reaction. That also can be find out by the experimental data. So, but if they mention in the reaction it is an elementary reaction, then you can take per element reaction. Order is a sum of stoichiometric coefficients. Of reactants. It is the sum of the stoichiometric coefficients of the reactants. Let us take example here. If they mention like this, 2A plus B gives rise to product. And apart from this, if they mention that it is an elementary reaction, if it is an elementary reaction, then we can say in this case the order of this reaction is equals to a stoichiometric coefficient here 2 and here 1. So order of this particular reaction is 3. So, like this we can see. So let us take a few examples of experimental reactions and their orders. But if they give the reaction like this chloroform, and if you treat with chlorine, we will get carbon tetrachloride and HCl. So here if you see this reaction case, it look like the second order reaction, but experimentally we don't know what it is. If they mention it is an elementary reaction, we can say second order, but actually experimentally they mentioned that the rate of this reaction we can write like this. Rate is equals to K into concentration of chloroform power 1 and concentration of chlorine power 1 by 2. So what it means here, order with respect to reactant chloroform, order with respect to chloroform is 1, and order with respect to chlorine is 1 by 2. And if they ask what is the total order of reaction, order of reaction, or it is a total order, means sum of the powers, nothing but here this is with respect to CH3Cl3 first order, and here with respect to Cl2 fractional offline. So 1 plus 1 by 2, and that is 3 by 2. The overall order is 1.5, and individual orders are like this. That is experimental, right? We don't know. They'll give. If not mentioned, you cannot say that it is 1 by 2 or this is 1, 2. We cannot identify. That is through the pure experimental analysis only. If I give the equation like this, if I ask to write the rate expression, means you cannot write it unless we don't have the experimental data. If you have the experimental analysis, if you have the some experimental data, then we can identify. How it is, we will see later. So these are the few experiments. I am giving some reactions, and the looks they are different, but actual theoretical order is different and experimental order is different. Let me take ester hydrolysis. This is a ester hydrolysis. Again, it looks like the second order reaction, but actually the rate of this reaction, K into, this is power 1, and with respect to water it is 0. Again, what it indicates, with respect to ethyl acetate the order is 1, and with respect to water the order is 0, but overall order is, it is a first order. Order is equals to 1, overall order, this is total order of the reaction. And one more, decomposition of N2O5. In this particular reaction, rate is K into N2O5 power 1. Again, it shows that the overall order is first order. Again, it looked, the stoichiometric coefficient is 2. That is theoretically, but actually experimentally it is 1. So again here order is equals to 1. Like that we have some reactions. Let me take one more here. A conversion of ozone into oxygen. Again here rate. The rate of the reaction is like this. And here with respect to ozone, the order is 2, and with respect to oxygen, this is a negative order. See, the order may be positive, negative, 0, whatever it may be, and fractional. Previous case we got 1.5, so it is anything. So here overall total order, or overall order, or total order, 2 minus 1 is equals to 1. So all these, whatever I wrote here, the rate is equals to this one, and the rate is equal to this one. This is completely experimental only. We don't know how to write this one. We cannot write simply by looking into the chemical equation. That will come later about the things. Actually, there are some intermediates are involved, that things are there later. Again, these are the some few examples about the order, how to identify the order. Whenever they give the rate equation or rate law. Next, rate constant. Already we have discussed for a particular reaction, rate is equals to rate constant into a power x and b power y. And here if we take, if we assume that concentration of A is equals to concentration of B is equals to 1, then rate is equals to rate constant. Means what? If the concentrations of reactants in a rate equation is unity, then we can say rate constant is equal to its rate. Then units for rate constant. And this is also very, very important, units for rate constant. So here the units of rate constant depends on the order of the reaction. Already we have discussed. That is, for example, if you take this particular reaction, then here units, that actually we will get K is equals to rate by concentration, reactants concentration power order, x plus y means order. Rate nothing but we know that molarity by second inverse, and again concentration molarity power order. Let us assume for zero order reactions. So units of rate constant is different for different order of reactions. For zero order reactions, rate constant K is the units of rate constant. What are the units in here? Molar per second inverse. If order equal to zero, this value will become 1. So in case of zero order reaction, units of rate is equals to units of rate constant. Already we discussed, that is mole liter inverse second inverse. And if it is a first order reaction, the units second inverse by molar. So simply we will get molarity will cancel out and left with second inverse. So first order reaction rate constant units and zero order reaction rate constant units are very, very important. Why? Because sometimes based on the units also we can identify what type of the order. if this is the rate constant units, and immediately we can say that it is a zero order reaction. If they give the rate constant unit is second inverse, so no need to mention now what is order of the reaction. You can say immediately it is a first order reaction. Why? Because according to the units of rate constant, we can say what is the order of the reaction. Next, for second order reaction, simply this is molar second inverse by molar 2. So then you will get molar inverse second inverse. Molar inverse means moles per liter. So then you will get liter per mole per second. So these are the units for second order rate constant. And similarly, third order, so on, nth order if you take. Second order, third order, fourth order, and so on, nth order. Then molar second inverse molar power n. And that can give a molar power 1 minus n second inverse. These are the units for nth order reaction. Or else, if you convert that into moles per liter, you will get moles power 1 minus n and liter power n minus 1 second inverse. And this is very, very important. So units for nth order reaction is mole power 1 minus n, liter power n minus 1 second inverse. Directly you can apply here. If it is a zero order reaction, simply in place of n you can keep 0, you will get mole per liter and second inverse. And if n equal to 1, first order, so mole will cancel out, liter will cancel out, only second inverse. If it is a second order reaction, in place of n you keep 2, you will get mole inverse and liter and second inverse, like that, so on. So better to remember this units for nth order reaction, rate constant units for nth order reaction. Then you can easily identify the other order of reactions rate constant units. And one more important point about the rate constant, that is about the units. Let me take again a general reaction AA plus BB gives rise to CC and DD. And for this reaction, I'll assume the rate constant is K. Then we can write a rate of reaction. K into A power some x, we don't know what it is, and B power y. A rate we can write like this also, that is 1 minus A with respect to concentration of reactants, with respect to reactant A, minus 1 by A dA by dt is equals to K into A power x and B power y. This is our, this is rate of reaction. Now I'll write rate of disappearance of A. See, rate of reaction is different. And the rate of disappearance, appearance, consumption and formation of individual reactants and product is different. So rate of disappearance of A means what? That is equals to minus dA by dt. And with respect to this dA by dt, if you write the rate equation, like in terms of the concentration of reactants, we can write this is with respect to A, then the rate constant here is Ka. And a previous case that is a different, and here this is different. And next, this is A power x and B power y. Let us assume that is equation 2 and this is equation 1. And this is different. Here K is the rate constant of reaction, and here Ka is the rate constant with respect to A. Why? Because we are taking this rate of disappearance of A. So it's corresponding rate constant. And here overall reaction rate constant. Now if you compare 1 and 2, Further, this first reaction I can write like this, rate of reaction minus dA by dt is equals to, the A will come here, A into K into A power X and B power Y. Now, this is assume 1. Okay, now you compare 1 and 2 from equations 1 and 2. What you will get? AK is equals to KA. Means what? Rate constant of a particular reactant is equals to the rate constant of overall reaction into its stoichiometric coefficient. So, simply we can write one general formula here. Rate constant of reactant is equals to K into rate constant of reaction into its stoichiometric coefficient. Its stoichiometric coefficient. So, from that equation, for the general equation AA, BB, CC, DD, you can write overall here A into K is equals to KA, similarly B into K is equals to KB, and C into K is equals to KC, and D into K you can write KD. And here from this K is equals to KA by A, and here K is equals to KB by B, means this is a rate constant with respect to B, and K is equals to a rate constant with respect to C, and here K is equals to rate constant with respect to B by D. Now overall you can write K is equals to, now KA by A is equals to KB by B is equals to KC by C is equals to KD by D. This is also very, very important for further calculations. Rate constant of reaction is equals to rate constant of particular reactant by stoichiometric coefficient, or else reverse, rate constant of a particular reactant is equals to rate constant of reaction into stoichiometric coefficient. This one. That depends on the order. Reaction rate constant is different. The order with respect to K is different, and order with the reactant, that is also different. No, no. Order of a reaction, you have to check it. So, let us take one question here. For a reaction, N2O5 gives rise to 2NO2, just it is a decomposition of nitrogen pentoxide, and it is found that decreasing concentration of N2O5, or there is a rate of disappearance of N2O5, is equals to K1 into N2O5. Next, this is product. So, plus increasing in concentration of NO2 by dt is equals to K2 into N2O5. And increasing in concentration of oxygen is equals to K3 into N2O5. This is the one. Then find the relation between K1, K2 and K3. Then find the relation. between K1, K2, K3. So what kind of relation we'll get? Overall solution for this. Let us assume the rate of reaction is equals to, what is that, minus d of N2O5 by dt is equals to plus 1 by 2 d of NO2 by dt is equals to, this is 2 times d of O2 by dt. This, you know, rate of reaction. Now you substitute these known values here. What is that, you know, for d of N2O5 dt means K1 N2O5 and this is 1 by 2 K2 N2O5 and this is 2 into K3 N2O5. This you can cancel out this N2O5, N2O5 and N2O5. What left? K1 is equals to K2 by 2 is equals to 2K3. So from this you can write 2K1 is equals to K2 is equals to 4K3. This is a relation between various rate constants of A, B. So I mean that is N2O5, NO2 and O2. So like this you can do the calculation, or else according to the previous formula director, what is that, rate constant K is equals to rate constant with respect to the reactant by its stoichiometric coefficient. Let us take K1. In this case particular reaction, K1 is means what, it is a rate constant for disappearance of N2O5. This is one, this K1, this is the rate constant with respect to the decomposition of N2O5, a disappearance of N2O5. What is the stoichiometric coefficient according to the reaction? The stoichiometric coefficient is 1. Next, K2. What is the stoichiometric coefficient here? 2 by K3. What is the stoichiometric coefficient? 1 by 2. Now, from this directly you can get this relation. 2K1 equal to K2 equal to 4K3. You can do by calculation or you can apply this formula directly. The rate constant of reaction to the rate constant of a reactant. And this is very, very important formula. And there is something about the rate constant. Now we will see some numericals. Anyhow, the factors affecting on the rate of reaction. So which factor mostly affect? The very, very important factor is concentration of reactants. Then how the concentration of reactant affects, if the concentration changes, how the rate of the reaction changes. And already we discussed that it will not depends alone only on the concentration, and apart from the concentration it depends on the power, that nothing but order of the reaction. So if you know the order of the reaction and the concentration, then we can identify how the rate changes for a particular reaction. Now we will see the numerical, then we will come to know, we will solve some numericals. We know that you can do this formula, change in rate is equals to change in concentration of particular reactant power its order. Because we have the basic rate equation like this. Rate equal to some constant K into A power X and B power Y. Sometime they may give in the numerical the concentration terms or volumes. If they give in terms of volume, then you can use this formula directly. Change in rate is equals to 1 by change in volume. Power order. Why? Because concentration and volume, the inverse relation, we know that C is equals to N by V, a number of moles to volume. number of moles directly relation to the concentration, but volume is inverse relation. The ultimately rate is directly proportional to the concentration. That is why inversely proportional to the volume change. Let us take few questions here. We have one reaction. A is giving products. Okay. So for this reaction, rate increases 2 times. When concentration of A increases 2 times. So for this particular reaction, rate increases 2 times when concentration of A increases 2 times. Then find order of reaction. Find order and rate law or rate equation. How to write the rate equation or order for that particular reaction. So generally for this reaction, how to write the rate expression or rate equation? Rate is equals to some constant k into a power x. What is this x? We don't know. That is nothing but order only. Here x is order per with respect to a. That we have to calculate. And according to that previous formulas, what is that? Change in concentration and change in rate. Change in rate is equals to change in concentration power order. What is the rate change here? Increasing in 2 times. So it is 2 times is equals to, no need to worry about this constant, and directly we can take this one. What is change in concentration? Concentration also increasing 2 times. Then what is the power order? What is the order here? X. From this, what is the x, Nana? X is equals to 1. So we can say directly order of reaction is 1. Then rate equation k into a power 1. So like this, you can identify the order and you can identify or you can write the rate law equation. This is experimental data. Rate increasing 2 times and when A increases 2 times means it is experimental analysis. Now by using this experimental analysis, we are calculating the order. You cannot write directly this is by looking into the stoichiometric coefficient, but anyhow in this case stoichiometric coefficient is 1, but order also we got 1, but it may not be equal every time and also need not be equal. Right, we'll see some other examples. Let us take one more question. A plus B gives rise to products, and here rate of reaction increases 2 times. When concentration of A increases 2 times. And when concentration of B increases 3 times. Rate of reaction increases 9 times. Again, just find order with respect to A and B and total order or overall order. Solution. Again, you can write the rate expression. Simply rate is equals to, so for that particular reaction, we assume that some A power X and B power Y. Okay. Here, first, if concentration of A increases 2 times, then rate. So in place of rate, you write 2. In place of A, 2 times increasing and power X. That's it. They didn't mention about the concentration of B. So from this, we can take x equal to 1. In the next case, and when the rate increases 9 times, concentration of B increases 3 times. This is 3 power y here with respect to B is the y. Then from this y is equals to 2. So order with respect to A is 1 and order with respect to B is 2. And overall order 1 plus 2 is 3. And if they ask rate law, so total order is equals to 3. And rate expression or rate is equals to constant into now A power 1, we know now the order, and B power 2. This is the experimental value. Again, if you see what is the equation, A plus B gives rise to products. But in this case, the stoichiometric options, if you see here 1, here 1. So if it is a theoretical rate, you can write A power 1 and B power 1. But according to experimentally, it is A power 1 and B power 2. A plus B plus C. Now three reactants will give the product. And here, first one, volume double, volume of reaction. Double. Then rate decreases to 8 times. If volume of reaction double, then the rate decreases 8 times. In the second one, increases 4 times. When concentration of A increases 2 times. And concentration of B decreases 2 times. And third one, rate of reaction increases 64 times. When concentration of C increases 4 times. Then find rate law equation or find rate equation. Or write the rate equation. This is a question. With the reaction A plus B plus C gives rise to products, here volume of reaction is doubled, then the rate decreases to 8 times. If the rate of reaction increases 4 times, when concentration of A increases twice and the concentration of B decreases twice, and the rate of reaction increases 64 times when concentration of C increases 4 times. Then how to write the rate equation? Can you try another this one?
A into A to the power of 2, B to the power of minus 2, C to the power of
rate is equals to
A into A to the power of 2, B to the power of minus 2, C to the power of 3.
A to B minus 1. B minus 2, C3. Well, if you check it, whether this is correct or not. So first we have to identify a rate a power x and b power y and c power z, let us assume. So these powers we have to identify, the individual orders and overall order. First one, what they give? Volume of the reaction is doubled, then the rate of the reaction decreases 8 times. So we know that constant rate change. Is inversely proportional to volume change. Power order. Right? And what is the rate change here? It is decreasing means 1 by 8 is equals to 1 by. And what about the volume? Volume is doubled. Then what is the order? This is for overall reaction. What is the order for overall reaction? X plus Y plus Z. Isn't it? From this, x plus y plus z is equals to 3. Let us assume this is equation 1. Next, second one. What is the second one? Rate of reaction increases. How many times? 4. So, 4 is equals to, with respect to A. It is 2 times increasing, so 2 power x, and with respect to b, it is decreasing 2 times. Decreasing means 1 by 2. Power y, and with respect to c, no change at all. So we have only a and b here. From this, you can write 4 is equals to, this you can write 2 power x minus y. Right? Then x minus y is equals to, you can write it 2. And this is equation 2. Next, what is the third one? And rate increases 64 times. When the concentration of C increases 4 times. So, in place of concentration of C, you write 4 and power Z. This is the order per C. So, from this, Z equal to 4 directly. Now you solve 1, 2, 3 and how z came for, z3 karna na? I wrote wrong here, just to correct. Z equal to 3. Now z value if you substitute in the first equation, what will get? X plus y is equals to 0. Then from this, x minus y equal to 2, x plus y equal to 0 means? X equal to plus 1, y equal to minus 1. Then now you can write, once if you know the order, individual orders, you can write rate equation or rate law. Rate equal to k into a power. With respect to a, the order is 1. And with respect to b, the order is minus 1. And with respect to c, the order is 3. This is the rate law or rate equation. One more question. For a reaction, A plus B gives rise to product, and the experimental data is given like this. So let us take the experimental data. We have the serial number and the concentration of A, concentration of B, generally in molar, and rate. First, in the first analysis, concentration of A, they have taken 0.01. And the concentration of B, they have taken 0.1, and then the rate is observed 1.2 into 10 power minus 3. The second case, this is 0.01 again. Now this is 0.02. Then the rate observed 2.4 into 10 power minus 3. In the third analysis, the concentration of A is 0.02. and concentration of B is 0.02, then the observed the rate 9.6 into 10 power minus 3 is molar per second. Here rate, concentration, molar, second. Now find rate equation. So just for this, like previous case, directly we have how many times it is increased or how many times decreased the concentration and rate they give. But here, directly the experimental analysis. Same concept is the same only, Nana. Okay, see Nana here. How to find out, or else still if you nothing is there, just you check equation 1 and 2, two experimental data, 1 and 2. Your concentration of A is not changing, 0.1, 0.1. So with respect to concentration of A, there is no change of rate. Rate is not affecting with respect to A. Only with respect to B, the rate is affecting. Here, the rate 1.2 to 2.4. Rate increases 2 times. When the concentration of B increases 2 times, then directly, we can say, so with respect to B, what is the order? 1. Isn't it? When the concentration of B is double, rate also double. So the order should be equal to 1. And the next. Now you check second and third. Okay, no? Second data and third data. Here, when the concentration of A increases 0.1 to 0.2, means 2 times increased. Then what about the rate? You check it. And B is constant anyhow. The concentration of B is constant. Now you check the rate. How many times it is increasing? 2.4 to 9.6, means almost 4 times. Just you multiply with 4, you will get 9.6. So here the rate change is 4 times when the concentration of A is increases 2 times. So 4 equal to 2 power x, then x equal to 2. So with respect to A, order is 2. Now rate equation. Rate is equals to K into A power 2 and B power 1. So just like in the previous question, they gave directly what is the change, but here they gave the analysis, complete analysis. Understood? So now next you will see integrated rate equations. This is a kind of third part, integrated rate equations. And this is also very, very important, integrated rate equation or integrated rate laws. We will discuss here mostly about the zero order reaction, first order reaction and second order reaction. So out of all this, first order reaction is very, very important. After that, zero order reaction, then second order, very rarely they lost. First we will go with one by one, zero order reactions. What is the meaning of zero order reaction? Here order of the reaction is zero. Then if the order of the reaction is zero, rate is equals to rate constant into reactant power zero. So rate is equals to rate constant. So particular reaction, if the rate of reaction is independent on the concentration of the reactant, and the type of reactions we can call zero order reactions. And also rate of the reaction will not depend on the time. You can define the zero order reaction like this. It is a chemical reaction. So a chemical reaction in which the rate of reaction is constant and independent of the concentration of the reactant, independent of the concentration of the reactants, a reactant substance. So for a particular reaction, if the rate is independent on the concentration of the reactant, or it is equal to the rate constant, simply we can say. Let us take equation A gives rise to products. For this you can write rate is equals to K into A power 0. And this type of reactions are called zero order reaction, where the concentration power is equal to 0. Simply, if the order equal to 0, the type of reaction is zero order reaction. But we can give the definition like this. Overall order. Overall order is 0. It may be. There is a possibility is there. Overall order should be 0. Let us take like this. A plus B. If two reactants involved. Okay, now in this case, you can write various possibilities are this. Rate equal to K into A power minus 1 and B power 1. You can write, isn't it? Or else you can write like this. That also is equals to K into A power minus 2, B power 2. We can write it when two reactants involved. Okay, now rate here we can write rate is equals to K into A power 0. Simply we can write rate is equals to K for a single reactant case. And rate is constant for zero order reactions. And for this we can write the integrated equations. Let me take again the reactant A, will give the product P. Let us assume initially at time t equal to 0, the concentration of A is equals to, let us assume A 0, then this is nothing. After some time t, then concentration of A, some amount of A is decomposed, let us assume some x amount is decomposed, then it can form some x amount of P. So at this particular situation, if you want to write the rate equation, rate is equals to change in concentration of reactant A, that is minus dA by dt, that is equals to, you can write minus d of change in concentration means what? Initial, final minus initial, final A0 minus X, and this is A0, and that we can write A0 minus X minus A0 by dt. This we can write further, A0 cancel out, d of minus X minus minus plus, we will get overall dx by dt. So rate of reaction we can represent like this, that is a dx by dt, whatever the amount of the reactant undergoing the decomposition, that is equals to a rate constant into A power 0 in simply a K. Here we can write dx by dt is equals to K. Now this you can write further, like dx is equals to K into dt. You write the fragment separately. Now apply integration. Integration idea is very important here. Apply integration for that reaction with the limits. So initial concentration at time t is equals to 0, the formation of product is 0, and after some time t, some x amount is formed within the limit of 0 to x. Dx is equals to K into, at initial time, at time t equal to 0, the amount of reactant reacted is 0, and after some time t, that is x amount. I think you know very well about this integration reactions. So integration of dx is x, and integration of dt, 0 to t, t. So x is equals to kt. So if you want to calculate the amount of reactant reacted at a time t, you can use this formula, where x is the amount of reactant reacted or amount of product formed at t is a time, it may be 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 15 minutes or so on. So further you can write this. What is the x value? That is a change in concentration of reactant. Here x is equals to change in concentration. Means what? What is the initial concentration and what is the final concentration? Anyhow, initially we have more amount. You can take A0 minus AT. Means at time t, what is the concentration? That is equals to k into t. This you can write in another form. At t, AT means here concentration of A at a time t is equals to A0 minus KT. This is also another way of representation. Sometime this, instead of representing the small a, you can see some other books like this. That formula A gives rise to P. You can take initially A0 at t equal to 0, at a time t equal to t, some amount, the amount of reactant left, that assume AT. Then change in concentration, you will get A0 minus AT, that is equals to x, change in concentration. So you can write here, instead of that small letters, you can represent like this also. AT means what? The concentration of A after time t is equals to initial concentration minus KT. So all are correct representations only, but in the different materials or different reference books, you can see in the different ways. Okay, now these reactions are very important. And here x directly, the amount of product formed, you can calculate. And here AT means amount of reactant left after time t, whatever the way. Okay, this is about zero order reaction. Similarly, if you take for gaseous reactions, in case of gaseous reaction, in place of concentration, we will take the pressure, partial pressure. So a pressure of reactant at time t is equals to initial pressure P0 minus KT. We can write like this also. These are the various formulas involved in zero order reaction. Next we will see half-life of zero order reactions. Half-life of zero order reaction. First of all, what is half-life? What is the meaning of half-life? And your life, half-life means time related. So it is the time required to complete half of the initial amount of reactant or half of the concentrations of the initial reactant. That time we can call half-life. It is the time required to complete half of the concentration of reactant. Or you can write the time required to consume half of the initial reactions of the reactant. Instead of complete, you can write here the time required to consume or to decompose half of the concentration of reactant. That is the half-life of reaction. So for in case of zero order reaction, how to identify this half-life? We know that the formula AT is equals to A0 minus KT. if t equal to t of, then what about the concentration of A at a time t? That is A0 by 2. Then you can apply that value there. In place of AT, A0 by 2, and this is A0 minus K. What is the time? This is a half life, T of. Generally, half life we can represent with the T of. Then from this, T of is equals to A0 by 2K. Instead of capital A, we can use this A0 by 2K. And this is the half life of zero order reaction. From this we can take here, anyhow 2 is the constant, K is the constant, overall T of half life is directly proportional to A0. What is the A0? That is nothing but initial concentration. Of reactant, and this is also very very important. So the rate of reaction is independent on the initial concentration of reactant for a zero order reaction, but the half life of zero order reaction is directly proportional to the initial concentration of reactant, and this point is very very important. So from this we can take one table like this. Initially we have 100% of reactant, let us assume, to consume it to the 50%. So how much time it will take? T50%, or simply T of. You can say T50% or T of. Again to convert 50 to 25, again 25 to 12.5, and so on finally to 0. Then how much time it will take? For 100 to 50, it will take 50% of time, let us assume. Then 50 to 25, again half life. So how much time it will take? So here T of is directly proportional to initial concentration. If the initial concentration decreases, half life decreases. If the initial concentration increases, half life increases. So for 100 to 50, if it is 50%, then 50 to 25, the conversion, further half of the consumption, it will take half of the T50%. Why? Because here concentration decreased to half. Ultimately, the time also should be decreased to half. Then again 25 to 12.5. Again half of this one, means 1 by 4th of T50%, and so on. Now you can see another way, 100 to 75. Directly to convert 100 to 25. How much time it will take? That nothing but 100 to 25 means T75% is equals to total time T50% and half of T50%. That can give 3 by 4th of T50%. Similarly, 100% to finally 0, let me take. So T100%. How much will get, Anna? So 100 to 50, to consume 50%, one half life. Again 50 to 0, to consume another 50, we required one more half life. So T100% is equals to 2 times of T50%. And these two formulas are again very very important. T75% is equal to 3 by third of the T50%, and T100% is 2 times of the half lives. It is also called time required to complete the zero order reaction is. Time required to complete zero order reaction is equals to, it is a 2 times of lives. Means simply we can write the formula T of, so T 100% is equals to 2 into T of means what, Nana? A0 by 2k, and from this T 100% is equals directly initial concentration of reactant by rate constant. With respect to the 100% initial concentration and with respect to half life, 2 half lives. These are some other important formulas. Graphical representation of zero order reaction. So simply graphs for zero order. These graphs also very, very important for zero order reaction. First graph with respect to rate versus concentration and rate versus time, like that. Let me take the graph. Rate of reaction versus concentration of reactant. If you draw a graph with respect to rate versus concentration of reactant, what type of graph we will get here? So as we know that in case of zero order reaction, rate is independent on the initial concentration of reactant. So if the rate is independent on the initial concentration of reactant, so you will get the graph like this. It's a constant line. As the concentration increase or decrease, doesn't matter, always rate is constant. In the next graph, rate versus time. As the time increases, the rate, again rate of the reaction is constant. So with respect to initial concentration of reactant and with respect to the rate, and this is constant. And the third type of graph, a concentration of reactant versus time. So with respect to concentration of reactant, what formulas we have, Nana? That is AT is equals to A0 minus KT. So now you draw concentration of reactant. Let us take AT. At a time T, what is the concentration of A, the graph? What type of graph you will get? This is Y equal to look like MX plus C. And here the slope is minus K, negative slope. So we will get the graph like this with negative slope. And the intercept, and this is 0, A naught, the intercept value. And what is the slope? Slope is equals to minus K. This is very, very important, this graph. The concentration of reactant versus time. What type of graph you will get? What is the intercept and what is the slope? In the next, fourth one. Concentration of product. Versus time. Concentration of product means what type of formula we can take? X is equals to KT, this formula here. Here what is the X? The amount of product to form. So concentration of product. So what type of graph? Y equal to MX? You will get the graph like. See, both here the concentration of reactant, decreasing in concentration of reactant. So this curve indicates that decreasing in concentration. Here concentration of product, the concentration of product is increasing. So both decreasing in concentration of reactant or increasing concentration of product, with the time they vary linear change, right? So linear change you can observe. The concentration of reactant or product. So this point also very important. Change linearly or varies linearly with the time. Next, fifth graph with respect to half life, all types of reactions over. Now let us take half life versus initial concentration, that is concentration of E. What type of graph we'll get in here? Again, we have the formula. Initial half life of zero order reaction is directly proportional to initial concentration. And like, we can take that formula, T of is equals to A zero by 2k. So what is the slope here? Slope equal to 1 by 2k. This is the slope and this is a curve. And these are some various graphs related to the zero order reaction. Mostly you should remember rate versus concentration, rate versus time, the concentration of reactant and the half-life graph. Very, very important, these graphical representations. Apart from this, some other graphs here. If you take like this, this is very rarely they'll ask you. A versus B. Let us assume here reactant, it is converting into product. With respect to both reactant and product, the graphs. We know that with respect to reactant and product, the concentration changes linearly with the time. So let me take here concentration and here time. Here the concentration of A decreases linearly. Then concentration of B will increase linearly. But here you have to observe the point very, very clearly. And that is, whatever the amount of A decreases, the same amount of B will increase. This graph. Initial, this is A related to concentration of A, and this graph related to concentration of B. And second type of graph, let us take like this. This is some extra information. 2A gives B. Here you can write the graph. The disappearance of A is the ties the formation of B. Means you can write like this. Let us assume this is 1 molar and this is 2 molar. If 2 molar is decreased, then 1 molar of B can be formed. And you can observe the graph like this. And this is concentration of A and this is concentration of B. Like. So according to the stoichiometric ratio, you can write it, the graphs. There are some graphical representations of zero order reaction. Examples for zero order reaction. Photochemical reactions comes under zero order reactions. Take hydrogen gas and chlorine gas. In presence of sunlight can produce HCl gas. So for this particular reaction, it is a zero order reaction. These examples you should remember. Sometimes they'll ask in examination which is a zero order, which is a first order. Directly this is a memory based, you have to remember. Next, mostly some decomposition reactions. Decomposition of ammonia and HI. Yes. They are also zero order reactions. Let us take ammonia. Can undergo decomposition on solid surface like molybdenum, metal surface. You can take anything. N2 plus 3H2. like HI undergo decomposition on the gold surface, it can give hydrogen and iodine. So generally photochemical reactions comes under zero order. So very very important point you should remember here, decomposition of gaseous substances on metal surfaces comes under zero order reaction. Simply you should remember, decomposition of gaseous substances on solid metal surface, decomposition on solid metal surface. We can take them as the zero order reactions. Next one more, enzyme catalysis reactions, they also comes under zero order. About this enzyme catalysis we will discuss later. Enzyme catalysis reactions. So these are the few examples comes under zero order reactions, completely memory based, you should remember none here. Okay, this is something about the zero order reactions and their examples. And in the next class, we'll see the characteristic properties of zero order reaction and some numericals related to the zero order reaction. So here we'll stop the class. Just you go back, just you revise it.